these creatures on the grave danger of worshiping of God than Allah. There is none greater than the Creator. Bismillah walhamdulillah. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillahi wa ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, dear viewers, to another episode in this series, Live Your Life on Purpose. My dear brothers and sisters, as we have discussed and remind you each time, the goal for each and every one of us is everlasting paradise, wherein we will be given anything and everything that we could possibly want and imagine. Now, while this goal should, in theory, keep us focused and should dictate that we live a very determined and a very purposeful life, the unfortunate reality is we become distracted. We become diverted by the beauty and by the adornments and the amusements found in this dunya, the consequence of which we forget ourselves. We lose ourselves. We forget our purpose, and we lose sight on this most tremendous goal. My dear brothers and sisters, this is a critical problem that each one of us needs to address. We must constantly strive to embody both the characteristics and the actions of the believer who is truly living his or her life for the hereafter, living his or her life on purpose. In keeping with this theme of live your life on purpose, we previously discussed the famous hadith wherein the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam enumerated the five pillars of Islam. He said, "Buniya al-Islamu ala khams: shahadati an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan rasulullah wa iqami as-salah wa ita'i az-zakah wal hajj wa sawmi ramadan." He said that Islam is built upon five pillars. The first pillar is the testimony of faith, the shahada, that there is no deity, in fact, worthy of worship, no God except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second is the establishment of the prayer. The third, the payment of the zakah. Fourth, mentioned in this hadith specifically, hajj. And then fifthly mentioned, the fasting of the month of Ramadan. My dear brothers and sisters, we previously discussed the importance of knowledge with a focus on the specific knowledge mentioned in this hadith for the first pillar of Islam, the knowledge of the Shahada, the knowledge that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah, and the knowledge of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam being the last messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for the last two episodes, we have been discussing the second pillar of Islam, the prayer, and its most tremendous importance in your life. Today, by the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we hope to continue this discussion with the third pillar of Islam, Ramadan. My dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, "Allah bi dhikri Allahi tatma'innul qulub." He says, "Verily, it is only through the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the hearts achieve tranquility." We will not find tranquility and inner peace through money. We will not find it through fame and recognition. The only way to achieve this inner peace and tranquility of the heart is through the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more you remember Allah, the happier you will be. And my dear brothers and sisters, this blessed month of Ramadan, this third pillar of Al-Islam, is one of the greatest opportunities by which you can increase in your remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, each and every one of you knows about Ramadan. You know that it is a month of fasting. You know that it is a pillar of Al-Islam. Every child knows this, for they're taught this much in school. What we sometimes forget, however, is the purpose of this month. The purpose of why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks us to leave food and drink for these 30 days. And the purpose is clearly mentioned in the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a verse that is almost universally mentioned when talking about this month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. He says, O you who believe, prescribed for you is fasting, just as it was prescribed upon those who came before you. For what purpose? Allah then mentions, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So what was mentioned as the reason? Again, so that you may become righteous. But my dear brothers and sisters, the word righteous does not do this justice. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, so that you may become from those who have taqwa, so that you may increase in your taqwa. Taqwa, my dear brothers and sisters, is the treasure of this life. And it is the treasure of the life to come. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. And take your provisions for the journey. And the best of provisions is taqwa. The best provision, my dear brothers and sisters, Allah says, is taqwa. The question then is, what is taqwa? Taqwa comes from the Arabic word waqa, which means to take a shield. As defined by the scholars, specifically it means to take a shield from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we understand the meaning of the word taqwa, immediately it becomes clear, without doubt, that yes, فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى, that yes, the best of provisions is taqwa. So my dear brothers and sisters, this is what Ramadan is for. Ramadan is for you to increase in your taqwa. But what else? How else does taqwa help? What other benefits can we derive from taqwa? And this is a fair question, because let's face it, we are a selfish creation. We care about me, me, me. How will it benefit me? What is in it for me? You are asking me to give up food. Not a big deal, it should seem. But you're asking me to give up food, drink for 30 days? For what? Taqwa? Okay. What are the benefits of taqwa? This is an important question. For if we do not understand taqwa and the benefits of taqwa, it may be hard to remain motivated during this month. It may be hard to keep focus, and we won't understand why we are really fasting. But for the one who understands taqwa, and for the one who understands that this month is a month to increase in your taqwa, for that person, they are excited about fasting. For that person, they want to be fasting. For that person, they are looking forward to this most blessed month of Ramadan, this opportunity to increase in their taqwa. So my dear brothers and sisters, when we come back from the break, inshallah ta'ala, we will continue talking about what are the benefits and the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for you as you work and strive to increase your taqwa. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
About 10 years ago, in January 2006, Alhamdulillah, the Peace TV network launched its first free-to-air TV channel, Peace TV English. Today, Alhamdulillah, it's the largest watched religious TV channel in the world, broadcast on more than 12 different satellites, having over 1.5 billion potential viewers and over 100 million actual viewers worldwide.
My mission of life is peace in every home.
More than 6 years back, in June 2009, the Peace TV network launched its second TV channel, Peace TV Urdu, having over 80 million actual viewers. 4.5 years back, in April 2011, it launched its third TV channel, Peace TV Bangla, having over 50 million actual viewers. Peace TV network is the first and only high-definition religious satellite channel network in the world.
Very shortly, inshallah, we'll be starting Peace TV Chinese, in Mandarin.
In December 2015, inshallah, Peace TV network will launch its fourth TV channel, Peace TV Chinese, in Mandarin. Today, the largest spoken language in the world is Mandarin, spoken by over 1.2 billion people.
And a beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that inshallah Islam will enter every home. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make me and Peace TV instrumental in making Islam enter every home.
You can tune into Peace TV Chinese from December 2015 absolutely free on AsiaSat 7, position 105.5 degree east, frequency 3704.5 megahertz, symbol rate 3.555 MSPS, FEC 3x4, polarization vertical. Peace TV Chinese in Mandarin. Coming soon. Thursdays provide.
In Britain, we are facing one big problem, that are you Muslim or British?
The space to talk.
In India, back home, they ask, are you a Muslim first or Indian first? And we Muslims should know how to reply, how to turn the tables over.
The place to knock.
Why Trinity cannot be regarded in that sense, Father, Son and Holy Spirit?
The opportunity to ask.
But even if you agree that what the Christians say, that he was crucified, so if Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, died for 3 days, who controlled the world? That means even God died?
The freedom to unmask.
So there are various ways which we can prove the argument to be wrong.
Let's meet Dr. Zakir every Thursday at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome back, brothers and sisters. Before the break, we were talking about the fact that the purpose of Ramadan, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, is to increase in taqwa, to get taqwa. And so we were talking about that we need to know what is taqwa. What are the benefits of taqwa? For the purpose of then motivating our fasting, motivating and giving us the desire to perform this act of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So firstly, the immediate answer is what we already mentioned. The fact that taqwa, linguistically, is a shield from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that alone should make it worth it. For that alone, you should not want to fast for just 1 month, but you should be willing to fast throughout the entire year, knowing that this is a shield from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a shield that without doubt each one of us needs to have and strengthen. What are the other benefits, my dear brothers and sisters? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ, that verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will only accept the good deeds from those who have taqwa. You want your deeds accepted? Then increase taqwa. Get taqwa. And this is important because we work so hard to increase in our performance of good deeds. But if we don't have taqwa, we cannot have those deeds accepted. This is tremendous, my dear brothers and sisters. We cannot have our deeds accepted unless we have taqwa. We work so hard at the increase of the performance of good deeds, but they can only be accepted if we have taqwa. So what else? What are additional benefits? Who among us has sins that they would like to be erased? Everybody should be nodding. Who among us has good deeds that we have done, hopefully for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hopefully in accordance with correct Islamic teachings that we have discussed? So you've done these good deeds, you're hoping and expecting a reward. Who among you would like that reward enlarged, expanded? Then go get taqwa. Then work to increase your taqwa. For this is precisely what it gives you. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يُكَفِّرْ عَنْهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِ وَيُعْذِمْ لَهُ أَجْرًا. Whoever has taqwa, Allah will expiate for him his sins and will enlarge for him his reward. Subhanallah. What an amazing blessing for having taqwa, my dear brothers and sisters. Additionally, who among you has difficulties that they are facing in their life? Perhaps a person has lost a job. We have a bad economy, I would say these days, but many days. Perhaps someone has bills to pay and they cannot pay the bills. Maybe the car is broken down and you don't have the money to fix it. Maybe there's a problem in your marriage. Maybe there is a sickness in the family and you don't have the solution. You don't know where to turn. The answer is simple. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Increase in your taqwa. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will make a way out for you. For He says in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. He says, whoever has taqwa, Allah will make for you a way out from your difficulties. And think about this. You did not have a way out because you could not identify one. You could not think of a way out. You could not imagine a way out. And Allah just said He will make you a way out. And listen to the rest of the verse. He then says, and He will provide for you in ways that you could not have imagined. Subhanallah. The blessing of taqwa, my dear brothers and sisters. So after going through these verses, we have identified many blessings of taqwa. And it is clear that having taqwa is vital, for it is the best of provisions. It is the means by which you have your good deeds accepted. Taqwa will provide you an expiation from your sins and a means by which you can have your good deeds enlarged, and your reward enlarged and expanded. And the fourth thing we mentioned was that for the one who has taqwa, Allah will make for you a way out from your difficulties. Subhanallah. So taqwa, my dear brothers and sisters, is huge. And this is precisely why we are fasting during that month of Ramadan. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ So that you may increase in your taqwa. This clarity of knowledge helps us to understand and to really appreciate the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us this month, gave us this opportunity to increase in our taqwa, to increase in our piety, and to become more conscious of our Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The purpose of this month, my dear brothers and sisters, is not for you to be hungry and for you to be thirsty. The purpose of this month is not for us to be lazy all day. And the purpose of this month is not for us to be grumpy and irritable and shouting at one another, which we often witness, unfortunately, when food is removed, the bellies are empty and people get hungry. This is not the purpose of the month. This is not the month of feasting. This is the month of fasting. So know the purpose, my dear brothers and sisters, that we may increase in taqwa, that we may re-energize our worship and our servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah gave us this entire month to recharge our taqwa, to recharge our taqwa batteries and taqwa shield, if you will. For unfortunately, our taqwa is not like the, you get the mental picture of the Energizer battery commercials of the bunny and the batteries that keep going, going. Our taqwa shield does not have unlimited battery power, as some players find in video games. It does not last forever. For in fact, during the year, our taqwa shield, it takes hits. We absorb blows. Our iman increases, and sometimes our iman decreases. Sometimes our taqwa will be stronger, and sometimes our shield of taqwa will be weaker. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave you this opportunity, my dear brothers and sisters, this month whose sole purpose is to increase and strengthen that shield of taqwa. Thus far, we have enumerated many of the benefits of taqwa. But what is amazing is that the benefits and the blessings simply keep coming. When the month of Ramadan comes, and I ask, are you going to fast? Everybody will say, yes, they're going to fast. Why? Because it's a pillar. In addition, hopefully if asked this question in the future, you will say, because you want some taqwa. We're going to fast anyway, right? But look at how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues showering His blessings upon you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever fasts the month of Ramadan with iman and while hoping for and expecting the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that all of his previous sins will be forgiven. Subhanallah. Something you're going to do anyway, for it's a pillar. Something you are hopefully now motivated and excited to do due to the goal of increasing in taqwa. Allah continues blessing you by saying that He is going to forgive you your sins for the one who fasts this month with two conditions, that you have belief and that you are hoping for and expecting the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear brothers and sisters, let us take advantage of this month. This is our month, our gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in fact, it is an opportunity. When the month of Ramadan comes, or if we are watching this episode and it's during the month of Ramadan, let us hit the ground running at the beginning of Ramadan. Let us take full advantage of this month and of this opportunity. Let us strive to fully recharge our taqwa batteries, thus fulfilling the purpose of this most blessed month. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ So that you may increase in your taqwa, so that you may become righteous. Until next time, fi amanillah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
He created the universe. To him belong the heavens and the earth. The ever living, he is the first. He's the owner of mercy. He sent his messengers to warn his